Thank you, Dr. Fava. Just a little bit of background. Our lab studies the pancreas and pancreatic functions, including pancreatic diseases such as pancreatic cancer and diabetes, which I'll be talking a little bit about today. We specifically studied the Hippo signaling pathway and its role in pancreatic endocrine cell development and beta cell proliferation. A few statistics. Diabetes is the seventh leading cause of death in the United States. This means that every 5 minutes, two patients die of diabetes-related illnesses. If left untreated, a symptom of diabetes is high blood sugar levels, which can cause damage to kidneys and other organs, and can eventually even lead to death. There are two main types of diabetes. Type 1, which is also known as adolescent diabetes, and type 2, which is mostly found in the elderly population. The course of treatment for type 2 diabetes, first course, is pills. But in the end stages of both diseases, insulin is the treatment because beta cells are usually lost. But there are, however, side effects of insulin injections, including low blood sugar levels or hypoglycemia, which can also lead to death. Beta cells are the insulin-producing cells that secrete specific amounts of insulin to control blood glucose levels. And because there are so many side effects of insulin injections, there is a lot of work being done to try to make beta cells within the body. So the three main ways are differentiation on the top left, which uses stem cells to regrow beta cells. On the bottom is reprogramming. We can use other pancreatic cells and reprogram them to turn into beta cells which produce insulin. And the last form is replication, which is something that our lab specifically works on to use beta cells that are already in the body and reproduce them so that they can produce insulin and hopefully eliminate or prolong the need for injections. As I said, we studied the Hippo signaling pathway, which is a series of genes that control organ size. And within the pathway, we studied the genes LOTS 1 and 2. The role of the Hippo pathway in beta cell development and proliferation remains unknown. And during pancreatic development, the gene neurogen 3 specifies endocrine lineage. This means that it determines what endocrine cells will become in their adult stages. And our hypothesis is that the Hippo pathway may play a critical role in beta cell development and proliferation. To test this, we use transgenic mouse models in which LOTS 1 and 2 have been deleted. And we found that our mouse models where our double knockouts occur are significantly smaller, as you can see in the picture. We also found that their pancreas and internal organs are also significantly smaller, which can lead to death after 3 weeks. As you can see from our immunofluorescence staining, smaller islet cells and fewer beta cells were observed in our double knockout pancreases. We also found in our HE staining that although there was a similar size of pancreas at postnatal day 1, we observed disorganized cells in our double knockouts. And some more immunofluorescence staining, as you can see, the green is YFP, which is a reporter that reflects last deletion. We also have SOX9, which is a ductal cell marker. In our controls, merging 3 becomes an islet cell and colocalizes with the staining for SOX9. And this means that eventually in the knockouts they become ductal structures instead of endocrine cells. As you can see, this is postnatal day 1, and SOX9 positive cells do not express YFP, which means that at this stage, disorganized ductal structures are not directly from LOTS 1 and 2 knockouts. So from this data, we can conclude that the loss of LOTS 1 and endocrine progenitor cells affects beta cell development, and that the Hippo pathway may play critical roles in merging 3 regulated fate decision process. And we are currently studying the effects of LOTS 1 and 2 knockouts in the earlier stages of development, and we hope to understand the underlying molecular mechanisms behind LOTS 1 and 2 deletions. We also intend to investigate whether LOTS 1 and 2 is involved in adult beta cell. of 2014, and as Kamali said, it is very much a family. Not only have I had opportunity to meet students from across San Antonio, from diverse schools that I would not have the opportunity to engage with in the small private school that I attend, I've also gained wonderful friends and mentors throughout the program, not only in the lab, but also with Dr. Chapa, everybody who works in the office. I've also had the great honor to meet three Nobel laureates and hear them present about their research, as well as participate in Vice President Joe Biden's Cancer Moonshot Initiative, which is determined to cut a decade's worth of cancer research time in half. This means that three of my ideas are being evaluated at the White House to improve the lives of cancer patients.
Thank you.